Hi, everyone. I'm excited to be here today to talk to you about some of the miracle stories that are happening right here in our own city, in our own state, every day. My name is Tony Kosha, and the title of our show is Tony's 50,000 Coincidence Miracles. Please note, this show is not about religion, and we're not trying to change anyone's religion, and we're not trying to get you to join any religion. It's just about miracle stories. I don't know of any religion on the planet that doesn't talk about miracles. That's why religions begin, because they have something that's telling them there's really a God. But we're not going to get into that. We're going to just talk about miracles and leave the decisions about all that up to you. So we don't care what religion you are. We just want to talk about miracles. If you are an atheist, I think you'll enjoy the program as well, although I can't guarantee you'll remain an atheist very long after you hear many, many convincing stories, coincidence kinds of stories about miracles. You can email me your own stories if you wish. We'll try to use all we can on the show. I can't guarantee we will, depending on volume and time, but you're welcome to send your stories on to us, and we will mention them when we can. You can send them to the following email address. But please notice that if we do use your story, we won't mention your name. We'll keep you anonymous. And we suggest that in your story, when you send it to us, don't use your correct name. That way, anyone listening will not be able to figure out that it was you that sent the story in. The email address you can send your stories to is very easy to remember. It consists of two words and three numbers. The first word is Tony, spelled T-O-N-Y. And the second word is and, spelled A-N-D. And the numbers are 777. So once again, the name is Tony and 777 at AOL.com. Well, let us begin. Our first hearing today is something that happened to me in the year 2023. It was a weekend day. It was a beautiful day for the beach, but I had so many things to get done. I decided to stay home and work on my projects. But after I started for about a half an hour, I got a gloomy feeling and inspiration that I had to go to the beach. There was something there important that I had to be there for. And I get that kind of an inspiration on occasion. And it's usually very true. I need to be there. So I packed up, took off, went to the beach. And the first person I meet, I get out of the car, I get out on the beach. The first person I meet was quite an experience. It was a person that I met exactly 1 year ago. And here they were on the 1 year anniversary weekend. They had been there with their mother in the prior year. And I came by in the prior year, gave them a card and talked about our books. And they got our books after that. And they read, she and her mother read both books. And they found it to be life-changing. It was a great blessing for both of them. So I was meeting this year just the daughter. And the daughter told me that the mother passed away just 2 weeks ago. And she came to the beach this day because she was trying to celebrate the one-year anniversary of how they came to the beach last year, and their lives changed ever since because, you know, we talked about things, about the books, etc., and then they started using them with great success. And so she's very confident her mother's in heaven because it turned her life around, the meeting last year and reading the books and, you know, just simply doing what the books say, keep talking to God all day long. I mean, that's the whole message of the books. You keep talking to God and he keeps responding and your life will change. There's no doubt about that. So I was very happy that I showed up because I was going to stay home that day. But for this woman, it was a great event because the three of us met there a year ago and she went to the beach today to commemorate the 1 year anniversary. And the only person missing was her mother. And we're confident her mother was there invisibly now, and last year she was there physically. You know, we're all going to pass away. We're all going to die someday. So when we do these commemorative things like, you know, celebrating the life of someone a year ago, you can rest assured that their spirits are aware of it and conscious of it. The next thing I'd like to share with you is that indeed God wanted me to get to the beach today because I met several people after this first woman, several people who I have met over the last 3 years, and I got a lot of input from them on how they're reading the books and listening to our websites, using the stuff on our website that's free. So let me share that with you again, the website address, so you can use our website address and get a lot of free information, okay? But remember, God inspired me to stop doing my chores and to get to the beach, and it was a great blessing because I just met this woman who's celebrating the one-year anniversary of her mother being there with us. And then I met several people, I think like five or six other people that day who told me they've been using the books and using our website. So our website address, there's free information there. I mean, you can listen to the book for free. It's an audio. And there's tons of things on there for free. Every one of our radio shows is on there, so you can pick them at random. A lot of people do that. They go on there every day, and they pick a different number at random, and it usually turns out to be something they need to hear on that day. So here's the website, so you can use it for free. It's wcatradio.com/miracles/. It's really like four basic words. Here it is again. WCAT, that's C-A-T, WCATradio.com/miracles/. Our next story proves that I really had to be at the beach this day, just like the prior two miracles that explained. I came upon a blanket with a husband and wife. They were really fascinated with the card and the story of our books. They asked me lots of questions, and then they confided in me. They've been married for like 15 years. They both have a walk with God. They both have faith. They both believe. They read the Bible. They read holy books. They both practice their religions. They have two different religions, by the way. What they told me was they're always arguing. They're always arguing about God or some concept. Turns out that the man is a scientist and he's a philosopher of sorts. She's very simplistic person. She just has her whole life just talked to God and asked God for whatever her needs were. She steadily just talks to God. She doesn't get into deep penetrating philosophy and theology. So they're always arguing. You know, she likes to keep it simple and he likes to make it complicated or more definitive, I guess. He likes to come up with specific proof of some famous people who have said things that they are doing. He doesn't just want to act on faith alone. So it was quite an interesting moment for me. I wound up answering a lot of their questions, and I was inspired to give them certain answers. And I got to tell you, the bottom line is this. At the conclusion of our talk, the woman said to both of us, you know, I prayed to God before we got to the beach today. I asked God to please do something at the beach today to help us to both stop arguing about God and religion, so we could have a wonderful marriage, because we have a wonderful marriage, except we keep getting into these arguments about religion. And I pleaded with God to please do something. And she said, I know it just happened. The fact that Tony came today and we're talking about these things, and, you know, it's helping both of us. And he the husband agreed. So what did I do? I just told him what I was inspired to say, that's all. And basically what I told him is what I tell everybody after 60 years of my life, where I did it wrong so often. I learned after 60 years, it's very simple. All we have to do is keep talking to God. That's it. It's just, if you could just take the attitude like there's nobody else on the planet except you and God, okay? Just try to believe for a moment there's only you and God on the planet. He's invisible, but he's there. And you can talk to him, and he talks back to you by giving you inspirations and ideas in your mind, okay? So let's say that's the simple equation. There's only two people on the planet, you and God. He's invisible. Every time you ask him questions, he answers you. Keep it that simple. And if you do that, I guarantee you, you're going to notice he answers you all the time. And you can look in the scriptures for two things. Now, in John 10:27, if you look in John chapter 10, verse 27, you'll see where Jesus says that he always does answer you, okay? And if you read John 14:26, you'll see where Jesus said the Holy Spirit will teach you all things, okay? So I think basically That's all you ever need to know. You can talk to God. He does answer you. And he said the Holy Spirit's going to teach you everything, so the Holy Spirit must be talking to you. And that's how simple it is, and that's what I told them, and they're delighted to now they know those are the two scriptures, and that's what they both have to do. Ask God what to do and listen to him. Everybody on the planet needs to do that, because in fact, indeed, everybody on the planet has God as a partner. We all have our own individual personal God. He duplicates himself, replicates himself, so that every one of us has him as our personal friend. We don't have 50% of him or 20% of him, or we see him once a week. We have him 24 hours a day. God is always with us. You see, that's how simple it is. So you keep talking to him, and you'll get all your answers and all the answers that you need. Our next story is a great story. It's a sharing from a man who tells us that he's been having back problems and leg problems that are really messing up his social life. He's not able to socialize as much because he keeps getting these aches and pains in his leg and his back. And he said this has been going on now for about 2 months. And he said he prayed the other day. He prayed and asked God to please help him. And he got some inspirations. And God showed him a specific exercise that he's been doing about 3 times a day. He said it takes 5 minutes each time, total of 15 minutes a day. And he does a specific exercise that has alleviated the pain in his back and the pain in his leg. He also got another pair of shoes. He was inspired to get another pair of shoes with some good support, an insole, a support insole. And it's made a world of difference. So I'm sharing with you. I'm delighted to hear that God helped him with inspirations to cure the pains that he was having. We got a great message from one of our listeners who tells us that one morning they opened the Bible at random and they wound up reading Psalm 121. Psalm 121 is a promise from God that he will guard your coming in and going out from now and forevermore. So it's a promise from God that he will always be guarding you as you're coming into and getting out of various things during your life. Meetings, presentations, events, illnesses, whatever, that God is always going to be with you. And he said that the rest of the day was amazing. He kept noticing coincidence miracles all day long that kept reminding him Psalm 121. I also read Psalm 121 many, many years ago as I was leaving a retreat. I had a 2-week retreat in Ohio at Steubenville, Ohio, the university there. 2 solid weeks. It was like living in Shangri-La, miracle after miracle all day long for 14 days. And I also, as I was leaving after 14 days, I opened the Bible at random, and I also landed on Psalm 121 that said, I will be with you coming in and going out from now on forevermore. So I personally know how wonderful it feels to have God tell you, I will be with you from now on forevermore. Our next coincidence miracle absolutely proves that God wanted me to be at the beach today. I handed out a card to the next person I saw, and the man looked at me stunned, in awe, and he said, he looked at the card, he understood it was about miracles, it was about God, and he said, you know, I've got to tell you, just before I got out of my car, I was praying to God in my car before I came out to the beach, Lord, please do something for me today while I'm here at the beach to help me understand your will. Help me understand what you're trying to get me to do in my life. I've got so many decisions to make. I don't know what you want me to do, what's the right thing to do. Please do something to inspire me. And here I come out to the beach, and the first thing, I didn't even put my blanket down. The first thing is I bump into you with this card about discerning God's will. And we wound up spending about a half an hour, just him and I, talking about his concerns, his problems and issues, and how God does answer all of those questions. God bless you all. I'll talk to you next week.